Good afternoon. We're about to begin our Great Lakes Festival concert. Thank you for joining us. It has been an absolute pleasure to train your students. And so we're going to begin with the festival band. We're going to play a piece entitled Beautiful Savior. It's also known as Fairest Lord Jesus. Okay, so the next two selections that the band are going to play have something to do with trains. The first one is called Funiculi, Funicula. It's written in 1880 in dedication of the brand new funicular railway that went up and down Mount Vesuvius in Italy. And so, you ready for some Italian? Here it comes, Funiculi, Funicula. Thank you.
During the American Civil War, in 1862, a daring Union raid known as the Great Locomotive Chase was led by James J. Andrews, a civilian scout. He led a group of 22 Union soldiers disguised as civilians in a mission to sabotage the Western and Atlantic Railroad, a crucial supply line for the Confederacy. The plan involved capturing a Confederate train named the General and destroying tracks and telegraph wires to hinder the Confederate war effort. The raiders successfully seized the locomotive. The Confederate conductor, William Allen Fuller, realized the severity of the situation and initiated a pursuit. A dramatic chase ensued, with Fuller and his men first running after the leaving train, immediately jumping on a handcar and using their own strength to pursue the fleeing train, and eventually commandeering a locomotive of their own. The Union plan seemed to go off the rails at every turn. Mechanical issues, lack of fuel, and of course, pursuit by the Confederate forces plagued them throughout the chase. Ultimately, most of the Union raiders were captured and some were executed. Many of those same Union raiders became the first recipients of the American Medal of Honor. This great locomotive chase became widely known throughout numerous books and films, immortalizing the daring escapade. We hope you enjoy this entertaining piece, The Great Locomotive Chase.
Thank you. maybe it's going to be deja vu all over again. Beautiful Savior, written in 1919 by F. Melius Christensen, was the flagship hymns of the famous St. Olaf's Choir. Panis, Angelicus, a Latin piece by Cesar Franck, really celebrating the fact that Christ is, his body was broken for us. He is the bread of life, and we're so thankful for that, and we've been trying to think about that even though we're saying it in Latin. I don't know if you have heard this extra-biblical parable, the parable of four neighbors. And the next song that we're going to perform really is in the spirit of this. Fred somebody, Thomas everybody, Peter anybody, and Joe nobody were neighbors. But they were not like you and me. They were odd people and most difficult to understand. And the way they lived was a shame. All four belonged to the same church, but you would not have enjoyed worshiping with them. Everybody went fishing on Sunday or stayed home to visit with friends. Anybody wanted to worship but was afraid somebody wouldn't speak to him. So guess who went to church? Nobody. Really, nobody was the only decent one of the four. Nobody did the visitation. Nobody worked on the church building. Once they needed a Sunday school teacher, everybody thought anybody would do it. And anybody thought surely somebody would do it. And you know who did it? That's exactly right. Nobody. It happened that a fifth neighbor, an unbeliever, moved to the area. Everybody thought somebody should win him to Christ. Anybody could have made an effort. But you probably know who finally won him. Nobody. Now, in the spirit of that song, you can, I don't know if you have a Jamaican place in your mind, but this is this story with a little bit of a Jamaican feel to it. We've got a soloist where hopefully he's coming here with his Jamaican-esque shirt, Ben Trueblood. And I'll give you a feel so you can translate what we're saying. Everybody said that anybody could do the important things somebody should do. Everybody knows that anybody could do all the good things that nobody did. And it goes from there.
Well, the preacher came by and tell me what I ought to do. If I wanted to make my religion true, he'd do it himself, but he really didn't have the time. He said that the duty was mine. Oh, no, no, not me, no, not I. Anybody could do all the good things that nobody did. Well, no, oh, no, 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 not me. Anybody could do all the good things that nobody. Well, the deacon came by and said, give me a hand. If you want to be going to the promised land, here is something that I don't have time to do, so I better give it to you. Oh, no, no, not me, no, not I. Anybody could do all the good things that nobody did. Why me? Oh, no, not to go. Anybody could do all the good things that nobody. Well, I'm too busy, so I tell everybody, do what's got to get done by somebody. It could be done by anybody, but nobody, 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 nobody did. Oh, no, no, not me. No, not I. Anybody could do all the good things that nobody. Why me? Oh, no, not to go. Anybody could do all the good things that nobody did. All the good things that nobody did. All the good things that nobody did. All the good things that nobody did.
That's great. I'll sit beside you for a moment. Tell the trick. All right. While they're wrapping up, if I could have your attention up here. There we go. I'm way up here. Yes. Thanks for coming today. I'm Dr. Dave Anderson, president at the Maranatha. And it's just a delight to have you here. It's been a delight to work with your young people over the last just over 24 hours at this point. So that's been joyful. All of the faculty and staff in the music department here have given a lot of time and effort to what they were doing in this, even in this program. Could I have all of our faculty and staff that have worked on this program, conducting, so would you stand real quick? I think it's appropriate for us to give them a hand. Good, good. Thank you, all the, there we go. I will tell you immediately, they don't do this just for fun, although there's plenty of fun involved in this. It is a labor of love and a work. Why do we do this at Maranatha? Well, really, it probably fits really into a broad picture of what Scripture teaches us about learning. If you're going to learn something, you need some truth, right? At least if it's done rightly. And as a Baptist university, obviously, we strive to teach the Word of God. But another huge part of that process is not simply having the right foundation. All Scripture is given by inspiration of God. It's profitable for doctrine, reproof, correction, instruction, and righteousness, that the man of God, the students, may be completely furnished unto every good work, all right? But there's also a part of that process called the teacher. We believe in Christian education around here. We really believe that it is critical for the next generation, for our young people, for our own children, to hear the truth, not just in a vacuum, not just from a fool, but from a godly person. That's why we're here at Maranatha. We're all about training that next generation through godly people. And Paul put it in a most just poignant way. He's writing to Timothy, talking about last days. I don't know if any of you have been looking around. It kind of feels like that around here. And he's bemoaning the reality of even people that in his day were resisting him, like they have resisted since about the fall. And then he says, now, Timothy, don't forget. And I'm going to read in 2 Timothy chapter 3. Evil men and seducers will wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. There are plenty of charlatans in our world today that look really pretty, rather angelic, and they are wicked. And so Paul goes on and says, but continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of. Now, he had already mentioned earlier in the book about Grandma Eunice and Mother Lois. And he's obviously mentioning himself here. In fact, he had just talked about his own doctrine, his manner of living. Timothy, you know who I am. And that's a part of your learning process, is learning to follow a godly believer in the Lord and walk in their footsteps. So you know, Timothy, continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them. And that from a child thou hast known the holy Scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith that is in Christ Jesus. Moms and dads, we take seriously the responsibility that you hand us when your children show up at our doors. You've given your life and heart to help them know the Lord. If you haven't, well, get at it now, all right? But when they come here, we see it very, very, very important that the professors, the teachers, the staff, the groundskeepers, the kitchen worker, are not just people fulfilling a job, but they're actually doing ministry, and they're ministering the truth to your children. So, yes, for these music professors, this weekend has been a flurry. I suspect they'll sleep pretty well tonight. But they didn't do it just to be a job, just to get their paycheck. Far more, and far more better than that. They are pouring their lives, their godly lives, into the life of these young people. And though we have them for a moment, in this moment, by the way, come back to camp this summer, all right? And then the application's right outside the door, right, guys? Anyways, okay, there you go. You come on. We want them to learn. We want them to learn Jesus Christ. Paul's famous words, and it's been a motivation in my own heart and life for years in ministry. What did he tell the Corinthians? Follow me as I follow Christ. What a humble role. He had readily admitted, I'm just striving to follow Christ, but come on, follow me. Maranatha is about helping these young people follow Christ for the rest of their life. And we rejoice that you've given us the opportunity today to just influence them for a brief moment. And if God would direct your steps to send them back here for college and university and grad school and doctorate and all that stuff, well, we would enjoy doing that too. Not because it pays our bills, though thank you for helping with that, but because you're giving us an opportunity to mentor. I'm the new guy around here. And as I've observed and watched our faculty and staff minister to the lives of these people, my heart has overflowed with joy to watch them diligently give their life to pass on to the next generation a godly life that loves the Word of God, makes it the heartbeat of their life for the rest of their life. I'm anxious to see in 20 years, if God would tarry, what some of these young people here today will be doing for the Lord as they're willing to follow godly mentors in their life and follow Jesus Christ. Thanks for coming today. We're not going to have an opportunity to necessarily pray at the end. I'm going to stop and pray, and then we're going to finish the rest of the program. I hope you've enjoyed it already. It's been a blast, and we'll look forward to the rest of it. Let's pray together. Lord, we are grateful for this precious opportunity that these dear folks, grandpas and grandmas, moms and dads, friends, have given us to minister to these young people. Thank you for the mission that you've called Maranatha to affect the next generation for the Lord Jesus Christ. And so as we understand learning, we don't just need truth, we do need that, but we also need it delivered by godly people that know it, love it, follow it, live it in their life, just like Paul was for Timothy. So Lord, bless the faculty staff here. Help these folks to give their hearts and minds and lives to you fully and then disseminate it to the students. Lord, I pray that even the young people that are here with us this weekend will leave here rejoicing in what they've learned, but leave here having taken another step spiritually, prodded along in their walk with the Lord Jesus Christ. May they hear one day those precious words, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant." Bless, Lord, the rest of this concert. May it be an encouragement and blessing to these dear folk. In your name, amen. Enjoy.
My name is Melody Steinbart. I had the privilege of working with the strings this weekend, and it has just been a great delight and joy to work with your students. We've had a lot of fun, done some hard work, but we're happy to present these pieces for you. Our first piece is Wonderful Grace of Jesus, and truly, if you know the Lord, you can truly be thankful for the riches of his grace and how he reaches down and pulls us out of the deepest pit and gives us that favor with God.
Thank you.
our theme is musical kaleidoscope. And so our string program is very kaleidoscopish in terms of its styles. So we're going to kind of change from the rejoicing, wonderful grace of Jesus to more somber, thoughtful, but very expressive air. And this is written from Grieg's Holberg Suite. It's a standard for string works. And this is air by Holberg Suite. Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Our final piece is a lighter on the lighter side. It's called The Syncopated Clock by Leroy Anderson. During World War II, Anderson served in the U.S. Army and was invited to direct the Boston Pops and wanted to write something special. So he wrote this piece, and you'll notice there's something funny about this clock. If you hear it, you'll hear the tick-tock, but there's something funny that goes on with the clock. I'll see if you can figure out what's the matter with the clock as we play.
Set up for the next portion of our program. We hope you feel like you are in the middle of one of those childhood kaleidoscope toys. Do you remember those things that you put up to one eye and twisted and saw all kinds of colors? Do you remember that? Anybody old enough to remember? Okay, glad I'm not the only one old enough to remember that. We hope you feel like you're in the middle of one of those with all the different sounds and colors and textures, different styles throughout the concert. In our opening session, we talked a little bit from Psalm 98 about a cosmic choir and orchestra that all believers and ultimately all creation will be a part of. And there'll be all kinds of instruments and singers. And that passage goes on to tell us that even the seas and the rivers and the hills and the mountains will all add their voice, their instruments, their color, their timbre to that praise of God. And all of that praise is driven by the fact that God is our Savior. That's an amazing thing. Whether we as musicians are performing
pieces that are specifically about worship and edification, or we're playing pieces about clocks and trains and other things. All of it ultimately we do as believing musicians for the glory of God. And we invite you now to help us in that endeavor. We're going to take an offering, and if you believe in what we're doing with this festival and what Maranatha's music department is about, we give you the opportunity, if the Lord leads, for you to share in that by giving in the offering. Of course, we don't want your tithes and your offerings and your love gifts to your own church, but if the Lord would lead you, we would love to have you participate in what we're doing through the offering. So we're going to commit this to the Lord, and the ushers are going to come. Heavenly Father, thank you for this wonderful opportunity to rejoice in your goodness through the gift of music. Lord, we're amazed at the beauty that you have created and that you've enabled humanity to make and enjoy. Lord, we know that we live in a fallen world where, because of what Satan has done and Adam's fall, it's easy for us to corrupt the good things that you've made. At the same time, Lord, because we've got your image in us, we have the ability to make and enjoy great beauty, and we thank you for that. We thank you for the opportunity to take that gift of music and give it back to you directly in praise. Now, Lord, we commit to you this offering, and we ask for your blessing upon the activities of this festival in the coming years and the music department as a whole. Well, thank you for it in your son's precious name. Amen.
Thank you. man. When they need someone to ooh, it's the man. When they need someone to awe, it's the man. When they need someone to rest. They think men can do it best.
As you can see, this has been a real joy to work with these guys this week, and had a lot of fun. We've also...
Can I talk to you?
I'm a little busy right now. We can talk later, okay?
But this is really important.
Oh, what is it, Griffin?
During this week of camp, we've been able to eat at the DC. And I think the DC food's pretty good, yeah. Don't you?
Amen!
Yeah. Amen. Yeah. But the DC food and eating in a big setting reminds me of camp food. And that stuff just, I can't stand it. Yeah, you know, I even wrote a whole song about it.
Okay, good, but we're kind of in the middle of something here.
Well, I was gonna ask you if we could sing it.
Sing it right now?
Yeah, like.
Do you have music?
Yeah, we got it all prepared. We all know it.
Okay, all right, there you go.
Here, can I put a suit coat on real quick?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh my, okay.
Thank you. It's inedible. Call it food if you desire, but it's inedible. How it sets my heart on fire. It's just incredible. As I force it closer to me, I can feel it oozing through me. With each mouthful, I'm reminded that it's really quite inedible. It's inedible. By looking, you can tell that it's inedible. Oh, how dreadful it can smell. It's just incredible. And tomorrow, when the aftertaste is gone, I'll still regret it. For no matter how I try, I can't forget it. it's inedible. It's inedible. Bring the stomach pumps with haste, 'cause it's inedible. Oh, how dreadful it can taste. It's just incredible. And tomorrow, please forgive me if my state of health is dismal, for it seems that I've run out of Pepto-Bismol. Believe me, it's inedible. It's inedible.
Well, Griffin, you just need to eat here more often. That's great. Good. All right, we're going to close it out with a song about heaven. And heaven is something we have to look forward to if you know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. You can know this. And so we take you to the throne room, to the coronation room in heaven. And hopefully you could say along with us, I want to be there.
Someday when the toils of life are over, and the saints are caught away, we will gather round the throne of Jesus for his coronation day. I want to be there when they crown him King of Kings. I want to be there when the chord of heaven rings, with a happy song the angel chorus sings. I want to be there when they crown him King of Kings. All the universe will be assembled, numberless the gathering there. Angel hosts in all the ransomed army, glorious sight beyond compare. I want to be there when they crown the King of Kings. I want to be there when the chord of heaven rings, with a happy song the angel chorus sings. I want to be there when they crown the King of Kings. Only those who put their faith in Jesus trust the work of Calvary will behold that crowning day in heaven, day of final victory. I want to be there when they crown him King of Kings. I want to be there when the chord of heaven rings, with a happy song the angel chorus sings. I want to be there when they crown him King of Kings. I want to be there when they crown him King of Kings.
All right, at this time we have our last transition, and so we're going to ask the festival choir to take their place, and we'll be get going in just a little bit.
Can do this while they're moving. We have just a few announcements, things we want you to know about, so we'll save a little time by doing that and just ignore the man behind the curtain, all right?
Yay.
We'll have some slides coming up here. We just want you to be aware of some things, resources available from Maranatha and some special events coming up. First of all, I hope you're aware that Maranatha has been producing some wonderful CDs of sacred music, and they are available online. You can purchase actual physical copies of the CD. You can also purchase them for download. They're available on Spotify as well, so I encourage you to check those out. They're really beautiful recordings that will encourage your heart. And then we've also got two special tour events coming up. I'm sure you know that Maranatha's choirs go on tour in early spring. And something we're adding to our tour ministry this year is a one-day festival. So the Madrigal Choir will be in Wisconsin coming soon, and they'll be doing a one-day high school festival at Camp Chetek. And if you are anywhere in the state or near there and would like to have your young people be a part of that, we'd encourage you to check that information out online or email us. The Chamber Singers will be doing the same thing in Michigan, and we'll be doing a festival at Camp Kobiak. These festivals will be a time of music making with the high schoolers joining with our college students singing. There'll be workshops and other kinds of activities going on as well. It'll be a fun day and a day that will strengthen them. And then we also have a special event coming up for young people who are perhaps thinking about music as a major or a minor in college. Now, the wonderful thing about music at Maranatha is anybody can get involved in it, and well over half of our student body is involved in the performing ensembles on campus. But if you are thinking about studying music for a profession, for a full-time ministry, we're going to have an event on February 9, a one-day event for students to come and kind of be immersed in the music department, where they'll attend classes and rehearsals, have a time to meet with the music faculty, and then that evening we'll be having our artist series with a wonderful guest artist, a cellist, who'll be performing some beautiful music. And it's a great chance for a student to explore whether or not God might be leading them in that direction. So there's information there as well. We'd encourage you to check that out and come join us on that day. And then, as has already been mentioned, we've got some activities this summer. Summer camp ministry, both for music and drama. And I'll let the slides go across there. We've got a number of different activities going on. A wonderful week of fun, of building of skills, knowledge, and discernment in the use of fine arts in life, as well as in ministry. So I'd encourage you to explore that and come on out if you never have. Bring your young people. I think we are ready to go into the final part of our program.
Thank you.
In 1941, on a very infamous day, December 8th, that's the day after the day that lived in infamy in the U.S., it was a day of infamy in the Philippines, actually, where the Imperial Japanese forces that had attacked Pearl Harbor also attacked the U.S. and Philippine bases in the Philippines and then proceeded to invade. And I'm sure you know that if you know your Philippine and U.S. World War II history. 5 years later, in the same month, December, a poet and composer by the name of Felipe Padilla was sitting on one of the few buildings that was still standing in Manila, because the taking of Manila meant the destruction pretty much of the entire city. The enemy forces were not willing to retreat from the city, even though their loss was certain. And so what it took for the Philippine and American forces to root them out basically meant the destruction of the entire city. And Padilla was sitting on top of one of the buildings that remained, looking out over a destroyed city, his home, a city that had been before the war one of the most beautiful cities in Asia. And he also looked out on Manila Bay, which was right there, calm and quiet, and he wrote a poem, kind of a half meditation, half prayer, about peace and quiet and beauty and a hope for peace, but with a sense of sorrow and maybe even a little sense of doubt that there could be peace. And then he set that poem to music, which we're about to sing for you. And you'll hear in the very introduction kind of a mix of the sorrow and the longing and a wondering, where are we going to end up? And then the words speak a beautiful hope for peace. It's a song that is kind of at the heart of Christmas in the Philippines, which, by the way, has the world's longest celebration of Christmas. They start on September 1 and go well into January. We love it there, so.
Our world is kind of headed downhill, but we want to end and culminate with this reminder. Rejoice, the Lord is King.
Rejoice, the Lord is King.
afternoon. Thank you again for coming. We are going to have to make a very quick transition. You get to be a part of this one. They got to do most of it, but it's your turn now. We have to turn around very quickly to get ready for basketball games later today. So if you want to continue to stay around and fellowship and enjoy the moment, we are glad for you to do that. But we'd ask for you to move over to the DC building, and the musicians know what they're going to do to move some things to help us make that transition. So thank you again for coming. And if you would, make your way out fairly quickly. Hate to chase you out after a concert, but that'll help our athletic department, all right? Thank you very much. Have a good afternoon.